Hello, hello, hello. Today is Saturday, July 27, 2024. You follow the solutions to problem 207. I must admit that it was perhaps way too easy, because in my lectures, and I tell you which lecture I believe, I effectively give you the solution. It's about Bragg diffraction. The solution is again a video solution from Keith Norman. If you're ready, I am ready.
This is Keith's solution to Walter Lewin's problem 207, and it concerns constructive interference. We have some x-rays and they are looking at a crystal structure, and we are dealing with Bragg diffraction. Walter doesn't directly cover Bragg diffraction in his lectures. However, he does go into great detail on diffraction gratings. So we'll start there. I strongly recommend you look at lecture 21 of 803, where this will make sense to you, even if you have to look at the lecture several times. There's a lot in it, and I frequently look at his lectures multiple times. On problem 206, I looked at one lecture, I think, three or four times over the course of a week before I was thoroughly happy with my own answer. Anyway, a diffraction grating. So we have Huygens sources here, 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 and apologies to Walter for the pronunciation of Huygens. We have a path difference, we've got rays coming in, a path difference of d sine theta must equal n lambda, a multiple of the wavelength of the light that we're considering, or it would be x-rays in our case. So n must equal 1, 2, 3, etc. That's what he covers in his lectures, lecture 21. However, for us, we have a different situation. We have x-rays coming in at the angle theta and going out at an angle theta. So we have an extra path difference here, which is the same by symmetry as this path difference here. So the Bragg equation becomes this equation here. And it's very simple. All we've done is we've added two, because we now have two paths to consider. And so that total distance must be equal to n lambda, where n is an integer. Okay, if you don't understand that, please look at that lecture. There is a gold mine in all his lectures. There are nuggets of gold littered all the way through it. It's not just the nice demonstrations, which are nice, but there is a depth of understanding that I don't often find in other people's lectures on the internet. Okay, so we just plug in the numbers. For the first order of constructive interference, I've let the angle be theta 1, and for the second order interference, I've let the angle be theta 2. For first order, n equals 1, for second order, n equals 2. So to find theta 2, I'm just going to divide that equation by that equation, and basically I get this here. Plug in the numbers, I get that there. Which becomes this. Plug in the number, theta 2 is 62.0 degrees. And obviously it's coming in there and out. Okay, and similarly I can then take equation 1, plug in the numbers again, and I get lambda equals 2.12 times 10 to the minus 10 meters, or in slightly old-fashioned but still very common units, 2.12 angstroms. Thank you. Thank you.